thing you're eating.
It's a video coming out soon for this artist that I have sitting here in the studio with me right now. And the funny thing about it is he wasn't even supposed to be here on the interview. It was just like, I was like, yo, he's such a dope artist. We already did a video. I should interview him now about what he's doing in life right now, man. And now we got Moonfu sitting here holding it down, man. How you doing, brother?
I'm here, man, trying to survive, man. You know, another day, man. Before, I want to give a big shout out to Alex. It's his birthday. Happy birthday, Alex. That's how it is, you know. And, you know, that's how I am, man. Yeah. I'm there, man, just working on the music.
And so much that the other day we were able to kick it, meet up, and write a new track.
Yeah, we got something, like, coming up.
Should I tell the people? I shouldn't have told the people yet, maybe.
You know what? It's no problem, you know. People are supposed to know. And people knows, like, you know, I'm like, you know. But you got to keep it on the low low.
Yeah, yeah.
Not everybody gets features with Moonfu.
For sure, man. And it was expensive for me to do that record with him. And he gave me some good smoke too.
That's what's up. He paid me with smoke.
You know?
That's what it is.
That's all it takes for me, you know. But yo, what's been going on with the music aside from, you know, writing with your favorite light skin? Like, what you been doing, man?
Bro, I've been working hard, man. I've been working like on some big ideas right now. Not only I'm working on my album, my Négativité 2. I'm supposed to like let it go on February and Black History Month.
People are waiting for it,
man. People are talking, you know, in French, but they're talking. Yeah, people been, you know, it's like, you know, don't forget, I did basically 4,000 copies of the Négativité 1.
Yeah, yeah.
So the seed's been planted, you know what I mean? So they're waiting for the next one. So
how does that feel as a, you know, to be able to go from the French, you know, to the English with the music stuff? Because not many artists could do that.
The thing is, it's like when I came here, it's like I wasn't that good in English. But when I started, like, you know, hanging with, like, artists like Aspect, and they kind of, like, you know, yeah, big shout out to Aspect. Congratulations again. You know, homie, like, you know, is doing big things.
He's got married and everything.
Yo, that's a blessing, you know what I mean? That's what's up. So with him, you know, like him, he's a good freestyler, and like his English is, so it got my English better.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So slowly but surely, I matured in English, because I was doing like a little bit like, you know, like kind of like, I was doing trap before these guys were doing trap, basically.
But your live shows are insane, man.
Yeah,
and the energy is always great. Yeah. I remember like one of the first times I think I ever saw you perform, you were talking about baking soda on the stage.
That song, bro.
And I was like, yo, this guy was, I didn't even understand what you were saying. I just knew baking soda. I was like, yo.
Bro, that song was like crazy. You know, you know what's crazy about like a lot of my songs? When, like, because I was up to so much no good at that time.
Right.
All these songs got actually put in front of a judge when I tried to, like, get out.
Hold on. Don't tell me about that right now. We'll come back to that. I want to ask about that in a second. Yo, Magic Mike, please, let's get into one of these records from Moonfu. You know which one you want to get into?
The track, I want to give a big shout out to Vamika Boni. She's doing, like, a very good, like, you know, she's in the scene. Y'all better add her. Add her on Instagram, or add her on Facebook. It's Vamika Boni. It's Vamica space Bony. She's very talented. I have her in this song called L'amour de ma vie. It's like it's gonna be one of the big songs on Négativité.
Is this in French or English?
It's in French.
In French, perfect. You know, so I won't understand what's being said, but I'll vibe out still.
It's called The Love of My Life. It's The Love of My Life.
You can translate it for me.
Yo, I can translate it for you, you know what I mean? You know, and I'm thinking about doing that for that video, especially. I was going to try to, like, translate the whole video in English for people to, like, actually.
Yo, I just thought about something.
That's what it is.
You're actually the first artist that I've interviewed that speaks French and is about to play a French track. And we all Canadian, so it just makes sense.
Exactly,
right?
Man.
Let's get into this record right now, man. Radio Game Radio, CHUO 89.1 FM. Oh, yeah, that's right, y'all. Bring your A-Game Radio, CHUO 89.1 FM. I go by the name of Dynamic, a.k.a. your favorite light skin. We still got Moonfu in the building holding it down. So, okay, let's talk about what we were talking about just before we went to break there with this.
Oh, bro, yeah, like, you know, when I was, like, you know, like, when I, like, those music, those, like that trap sound, like, that I had, it was so real at the time. Like, when I went to court and tried to get, like, a bail, and they said, they brought my lyrics up. They said, no, his music, we don't believe that this guy is going to be doing music that's going to be helping the community. Yeah. Look at the music he already has out there, and they brought one of my songs called Cocaine and one of my and Baking Soda. It's crazy. They translated the French track for the judge.
Right. But what are some of the lyrics? Let me take the beat down. This is big. We're going to find out. What are some of the lyrics like in that Baking Soda one?
The Baking Soda was
try
like,
to keep it clean for the people.
Was Baking Soda, cocaine. Baking Soda, cocaine. Baking soda, cocaine. And if you mix it together, you'll be a rich man. Go get your baking soda. We got the cocaine. Go. That was out of control. You know,
as much as I don't condone those lyrics, I'm a grown man now. Dad and everything. I don't condone those lyrics. You know? But the energy when you perform that, brother, the whole crowd goes crazy.
Yo, out of control.
I'm even there, and I don't even know what you're talking about.
Yo, it was out of control. Some people didn't even know about that mixture. What?
They probably went home and tried it. Baking soda and coke.
People was like, yo, I remember someone said, oh my God, like, if you didn't say cocaine, I thought you were talking about some baking mix. Yeah. Like, so you were baking a cake.
Yeah. I don't know why they. I mean, I get why they would try to use that against you, but the energy when you perform that, brother, is so live.
It's a whole nother ball.
Get out of here with it, man. We're talking about music, too.
No, it's all about music. But, you know, I did the song. I remember I featured, I have it on my, my mixtape, Le Rêve d'être célèbre, Volume 2.
A translation on that would have been
the dream to be a celebrity. Volume 2, Philosophy of a Hustler. That was the
anytime you send me something, just send me the Google translation.
The Google translation. You got it.
I respect
you. And that's it. You know, I had I remember I had Gutter Kid on it.
Shout out to Gutter Kid.
Big shout out to Gutter Kid. Find Your Own Movement. Big shout out to 6-1 Trey and all the team there.
Yo, I'm glad you mentioned those two guys there too, because they came by the Hip Hop Food Drive.
Oh, yo, they give. They give like whatever. Oh, yeah, those guys.
They stopped by. They held
great
down.
Great people.
And I want to shout you out too, because you held it down at the fourth annual Hip Hop Food Drive too, man. And your performance was insane. It was live.
No choice, man. Respect.
Yeah.
Even Vanessa gave me some blessing on that. You know, and that's what's up.
How do you feel like when you know that you've done a good job performing after people come up to you? And
yo, it's big. You know, it's like that's the satisfaction. It's better than money. It's like, you know, people like don't know. It's like me, I'm all about that. People don't understand like how hooked I'm in to performing.
Right.
Like when I know I'm gonna perform, I'll be like I'm really preparing to perform.
Right.
You see what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like it almost like even it's so crazy. Like I was like telling my homeboy in Montreal, I said, bro, because we had like kind of a problem. Like I went to perform and they short me the time, you know, there were so many artists and you know, and I'm like, yo, you don't understand. Like, bro, I'm like Ben Affleck in The Accountant. You know what I mean? When I'm here to do something, if I come and I end up doing 5 minutes, one song, I go home and go crazy because I was planned. I planned something. I planned a performance. I want to give my all. I don't want to come there, and I only could do half of it. And I'm like, but I can't reach my public like that. Yeah. You see what I mean?
And you always bring the energy when you do the shows, man.
That's what it is.
Let's get into another record here, man.
Yo, the song I'm going to do right now is called Single Mothers. I dedicate this one to my mom and to all the single mothers out there.
Shout out to my mom.
Yeah, man. Like, you know, for all those who's raising kids on their own. Yeah, man, I did this song called Single Mothers. Respect.
Let's do this, man. Bring A-Game Radio, CHRO 89.1 FM. Magic Mike, drop that for the people.
Independent.
All right, 10 p.m. until midnight, CHRO 89.1 FM. Finally got the drop from Moon Foo. Live in the building.
That's what it is, man.
This is crazy because We don't always do that live drop right there.
No, like, that's real, that's crazy.
We pulled it out.
What's up? We pulled it out on the spot.
On the spot.
I like that.
We have to get one from everybody that comes through here.
Exactly.
Now,
they have to
on the spot. You christened it.
Yeah, exactly. Like, you know, I'm an innovator. Man.
First French
like,
artist for like, all of that.
Yo, I like being the innovator.
Where can people follow you online once again, man?
Yo, right now you can find me I got my Facebook page, Munfu, MUNFOU. And also you could always check me on Munfu TV on Instagram. And of course, it's Munfu TV on YouTube. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Always gonna have new music, always new videos coming up. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's what it is.
Any plans on a new video?
Right now I'm working on the next video. I'm working right now is Hustle, and like Hustle is gonna be crazy. Watch out! I'll be needing like maybe 15 to 20 people. To fill a classroom. I'm gonna bring them. That's the whole concept of the video.
I'm in there. Let me
know.
Oh
yeah, no problem. So I'm trying to get like 20 people.
Vanessa said she's there too.
You know, that's what's up. That's what's up. I'm trying to bring everybody in there and trying to get this video popping. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna be a teacher, and I'm gonna show people how to hustle. And that's the concept of the video.
Okay, I'm coming to learn, man.
Oh yeah, that's what's up, man. You know, that's what it is. Man.
Magic Mike, you coming too?
You know?
Where?
No, you know,
say La Genesis is coming too. I'm lining up everybody in there. We're coming to learn, man.
That's what's up. We're going to show people how the art of the hustle. And the thing about the hustle, I'm going to do in the remix too.
Yeah.
So the remix is crazy. The remix, I got D Chase.
Ah, shout out to
D Chase. You know, from the Triple M Lefty Lane. You know, from they're in Toronto, but they do back and forth.
Yeah, yeah.
So I got D Chase on there. I got Seul. I don't know if y'all know, but Seul is hard. It's a French artist called Seul. You know, I think on Instagram is Seul, is Viking Seul. Or something, but on Facebook I know it's Seul de Bus. He just got a new video called "Mourir Riche," means die rich. Sick. The guy's flow is crazy. And I have Jack and Castro.
Okay.
Jack and Castro is another Asian group from Montreal.
Okay.
And you know, and that's crazy. And they're on that song. So I'm trying to make a big remix and put, you know, like really do a collaboration with like different cities, because you know, D Chase is in Toronto,
right.
Me, I'm here, homies are in Montreal, so I wanted to like
triple city glue. Connection.
Yeah, exactly. I wanted to make something like that, so I made it happen.
Big.
And that's what it is, you know. So that's the main focus, is the hustle. And I got another video I'm working on too. It's gonna be animated. It's a whole animated video.
Jeez.
It's crazy. It's called it's a Creole song, and it's crazy. It's like it's called This Whatever. I'm not gonna say.
Is that the one that you let me hear?
Yeah,
that.
That's okay, the one, yeah. That one's crazy.
Yeah, I even heard that.
Yeah,
yet, man,
it's crazy. So I got that going on, and for sure, and a lot of like a low key thing I'm working on for every artist in the city. If you know how to sing, if you know how to like, you know, you. I'm actually working on a musical. That's what's up. I'm actually trying to make a hip hop musical. I'm organizing it. I'm gonna have like different videographers on it and stuff like that, because I write so many songs, so many stories. So I thought about it, like, you know, maybe like, you know, like invest, like, you know, people are investing so much money in videos and stuff like that. I'm like, you know what? Why not I just do a strong 30, 40 minute musical all together, all different, you know, scenario, and glue it together and give it like something that's very kid friendly, that very teenager friendly. I don't want to be like, I want it to be like kind of like educational and like, you know, to stay away from the street, away from the gangs. Like I want to create, I'm sitting down with some script writer, like,
you want to teach?
Oh yeah, I want to teach. That's what I want. I want to like really be involved in with the community. I want to because the thing is, the guys that's doing the negative, they don't know how to like show these kids that, yo, whoa, bro, it's not really that life.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? Me, I'm trying to do, yeah, I could do a track that I'm talking about the trap life, but at the same time, I want to make sure the kids know that, yo, bro, I'm not in this world no more. This is just the beat bumps.
Right. And there's that one record that, you know, and video that you released not too long ago where...
Oh, Dedication.
Dedication, and you kind of...
Yeah, I'm trying to tell everybody, like, you know, like, basically my struggle. Like, yeah. You know, how I came from the bottom. I never seen the top, but I still got my dedication. You see what I mean? I'm still doing this thing. I still try to reach out. Even the videos, you see, I'm always trying to do videos with the kids. Because I used to, like, always say, oh, let me bring all these guys in my video. And I'm like, you know what? Y'all have too much crazy stuff going on. I've seen too many situations where, like, okay, you bring a bunch of guys in a video, and next thing you know, one of these guys do something weird. Mm-hmm. You get caught doing something weird. And next thing you know, in your commentary and your comment section of your video, oh, you have this so-and-so up there, he did this, that. I'm like, whoa, I'm not even, yeah, the guy just showed up to my video. Like, nah, I'm like, you want to associate me with so-and-so.
Yeah,
so
you can't do a criminal check on everybody.
Yeah, I can't do it. Like, exactly. So that's why now, if it's not someone that I know, an artist that I know or whatever, I'm not putting you in my video. That's why I like, but the kids, I love putting them in my video because it gives them, like, you know, like a sense of belonging that, you know, at least I could put. Because you see that video, Dedication, I'm about to go put it in a, I'm going to put it in a Much Vibe because I want these kids to be able to one day watch the television set and see themselves.
Well, I gotta be in one of your videos coming up, man, bro, at some point, you know what I'm saying? Up. And vice versa.
Oh, yeah, man, we got some crazy stuff working.
I can't promise you people aren't going to reach out and comment under your stuff, but... But, yeah, let's get into this video, man. You know, the record that we talked about for the video there.
The Hustle, man. Yeah. The Hustle is the hype.
Actually, no, I want to do the Dedication.
Oh, do the Dedication. But before I have to give shout out to Emmerich, who's on the chorus. I think he came from France. He's back here. Yo, bro, I'm happy that you're in the city. You have to hit me up, by the way. And I got to give a big shout out to Sasha, too. Like, beautiful voice. I have her in that record too, Dedication. And I want to give them a big shout out. Thank you very much for hooking it, for giving me the opportunity to expose y'all talent to the people, because a lot of people don't know about these artists. Yeah. And I'm trying to bring them out.
I like that during this interview you've mentioned about like five or six different artists. Not a lot of artists will take the opportunity to mention other artists and big them up. Shout out to you for that, man.
Yo, bro, let me tell you something. A lot of artists in the city is very selfish, and
they're not actually like selling fish. Yeah, like they're
very selfish. You know what I mean? Exactly. Because the thing is, you see how selfish they are, even under projects. You know, they don't include other people. Me, I include the beat makers from the city. Like, big shout out to Kamali Jordan. Big shout out to Sino. Sino is talented as hell. I had to because I used to use other beat makers before, I gave them their chance, and now I'm like, oh, there's other beat makers. I gotta start focusing on the new talent, because some of them don't, because some other beat makers I worked with, maybe they don't understand how much I'm giving them. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
Because don't forget, I put your name on 5,000 copies. Yeah, maybe I couldn't give you $1,000 for your beat, but 5,000 people have your name.
Yeah.
Now, if you can't go with that and make something out of yourself, that's not my, you see what I mean?
Yeah.
And that's the thing, too. That's the balance you have to have. Like, if the guys are not music orientated, they're not balanced, you have to go and move to the other, because there's other talent. There's actually other talent. My goal is not to sing forever. I'm all about other talent because, there is other talent. I want to write a hit for another. Maybe I don't get the million.
Yeah.
I could write a song for so-and-so and she hit the million.
And you're working with the other artists and building.
Oh, yeah. That's what it is. That's why I'm doing the musical, so I could expose real talent, black talent as first and foremost.
Yeah.
You see what I mean? Because that's what's dark. They don't show us enough.
Right. So it's dope that you highlight, you know, other people.
Oh, yeah, man.
It's
I got to give a big
I feel like
highlight.
Maybe I should do that for other radio shows, but then I'm like, no, they all suck. Let's get into...
except for Magic Hour.
Anything that's on
stage, yeah, exactly. Yeah, yeah. Thank you for saving me there.
Everything's yours. The top, yeah. Top show.
Shout out to all the other radio shows. But we the best. All right, let's get into this record, this dedication one.
Yo, man, that's what's up, man. I love dedication, man. I want to give a big shout out to Lower Town, all the people in Lower Town. I want to give a shout out to Margot's Restaurant. You know, they've been a big support when I was doing my video in the community there. Margot's helped. And I want to give a big shout out to everybody, man. And stay in school, kids. That's how it is, man.
Let's go.
Bring your